Hey folks, thanks for watching my video. If you are new to my channel, subscribe now and ring that bell for future notifications. Thanks. Hey folks, today I am recapping Saban's Go-Go Power Rangers, issue number 21 in the Necessary Evil story arc, written by Ryan Parrott and Sina Grace, and illustrated by Francisco Mortarino. This comic starts us off 1 year after arrival day, in a very familiar setting. Kim and Tommy are on a date and trying awkwardly, you know, to build chemistry at the movies. For those of you who are familiar with the Shattered Grid, then this scene is definitely familiar because I'm sure you, like myself, were expecting Lord Draken to come behind Tommy and stab him in the back with the Saba Saber. That Lord Draken guy, he's a jerk. But no, the exact opposite happens. Kim runs back to Tommy to tell him how she really feels, and they go in for the kiss they both wanted in the first place. They both realize, hey, we are superheroes and we're teenagers. We don't have to keep secrets. However, their secret of being Power Rangers is the thing that makes chemistry for these two in the first place. Flashing over to Angel Grove, several months later, the Power Rangers are fighting a giant-sized monster, and they're getting their butts handed to them. The Green Ranger shows up in the Dragonzord to assist very briefly, which caused a nice window of recuperation for the Megazord. And then the Power Rangers destroy the monster. Bada bing, bada boom. Now back at the command center, the Rangers are unmorphed, and Tommy apologizes to the team for teleporting out midway in the battle. He honestly had no choice, seeing as his Green Ranger powers are fading away, due to the effects of the green candle spell Rita cast before she was banished by Lord Zedd. All the friends are very supportive and trying to figure out how to save and preserve Tommy's Green Ranger powers. Jason the Red Ranger takes personal responsibility because he couldn't stop the green candle in the dark dimension. But Tommy assures them, you know, that sometimes you enter a fight and you lose. Just being a Power Ranger is something no one can take away. And that's the hope Tommy currently is holding on to. Going on, we see that Lord Zedd seems to be in a really good mood. I'm sure his partnership with Dane, the hottest dog in the galaxy, is the reasoning for his bright spirits. He seems to finally have figured it out. He finally has a way to bring an end to the Rangers, one by one. Back at Angel Grove High, the Rangers are eating lunch and conversing about, you know, how to save Tommy's powers. Again, in the midst of this conversation, the Rangers' communicators, they go off. Alpha 5 informs the team that Lord Zedd has sent putties into Angel Grove Park, terrorizing the community. Of course, you guys know what time it is. It's Morphin time! However, Tommy has to sit back and watch his friends save the day as his powers are very limited and fading very quickly. Even as the Rangers are fighting the putties, they can't help but feel bad and think about Tommy because, let's face it, if you were in his shoes and monsters and aliens were terrorizing the world and your group of friends needed your help but you couldn't do anything about it and you had to stay and watch, you might be frustrated as well, or at least a little agitated because you couldn't do all the superhero stuff and wear a dope outfit. Anyway, it's evident all of this is affecting Tommy. So Kim, she catches up with him and notices he's got a few bags packed. Tommy is gonna stay at a cabin his uncle owns for a while, away from Angel Grove, to clear his head. There's more to being a Power Ranger that keeps him, you know, connected with his friends and Kim, but not being a Ranger has caused a disconnect for Tommy. Basically, he just needs time away to find himself. And I'm sure there is a light at the end of the tunnel. See what I did there? That was a reference to the White Light episode, you know, the White Ranger. Anyway, moving on. Jason Lee Scott, the Red Ranger, is training and taking some stress out, as it seems he too is frustrated he can't do anything to save Tommy's powers. As he's training, he hears a voice telling him it's not his fault. This Green Ranger never survives. I am the one who helped you rebuild the universe. It's then revealed to be one of the Morphin Masters that has confronted Jason, which I'm sure plays into the new reveal of Jason, Trini, and Zach being the Omega Rangers. To be continued. Wow. Do you guys ever read these comics and feel like you just watched the TV show yet 10 times better? That's basically how I feel most of these issues. What will happen with Tommy? Will he lose his Green Ranger powers again? And what about Lord Zedd? What's he up to? And the Morphin Masters? Why did they confront Jason about saving the universe? And why does it seem so secretive? Now look guys, I don't have all the answers to these questions, but make sure you are subscribed to my YouTube channel so you can find out what happens next in Saban's Go-Go Power Rangers. This full issue is now available at Comixology and at your local comic book shops. Thank you guys so very much for watching. Again, if you are new to my channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button and ring that bell so you get all of the notifications on my videos. Until the next issue, Ranger Nation, wham, bam, boom.